Welcome to our Orange Root semester. This is our very last semester of Let's Play Music. Can you believe you are so big now? You are ready for our Orange Root semester. Check out all of our fun orange stuff in our studio. Lots of orange carrots. And look, Mr. Rabbit has his own carrot wand. That means he has magic all the time now. He already has come to life. Should we show off for him one last time how we know how to sing? Sing it with me. Do is home. I'm going to check myself. Do is home. And right now, do is C. But we can sing up in our head. Sing with me. Do. Fa, let's check ourselves. Right now, do is F. What did it sound like when it was C? Can we sing our song in C? Let's play music, music, music. Open up your books to page one. Big long J and a capital D. Swoop around the second line, cause that's a G. Did you hear my pattern? Bum, bum, bum. Did they sound like so, so, do? Yes! Okay, today we're gonna do it a little bit different. Now that we're in Orange Roots, we're going to listen and write, but not only are we going to listen to what the notes are, we're gonna also listen for the rhythm. Ooh, this is dictation. Can you say that word? Dictation. When we listen to music and then we write down what we hear. Okay, so we can see that we did our big long J and our capital D, swoop around the second line, because that's a G. And what is our dictation starting on today? What letter do you see? Is there a middle C there? What key are we in? Do you see any sharps or flats? We have no sharps or flats, you see. So we're in the key of C major. And when I'm in the key of C major, C is do. So my dictation today is starting on a do. Okay, now I said we're gonna be listening to the rhythm as well. So I'm gonna have Mr. Beatbug help us out. He's gonna give us a beat. Not only will we be listening to the notes, we're gonna try to hear what kind of notes these are. Notice I haven't filled it in or anything yet because I'm not sure what note it is. This is gonna be our do here. What did you hear? Did you hear how many total notes there were? Could you hear what kind of notes, how long they were getting held for? Listen to it again. Could you hear? I think I heard five total notes. Did you hear five total notes? And how are they moving? Did you hear it moving up and then down? Ooh, what do you think? Does it sound like they're moving by baby steps or skips? Let's listen to it one more time. I think I heard it doing baby steps up. I'm gonna turn off Mr. Beatbug for a second. Could you hear how long were each of those notes getting held for? I think they were half notes, so I don't need to color my first one in. And then I heard it going up. Did you hear it going up? If it went up a baby step, it went up to a middle D. I can add my stem. It went up again. Made it up to a middle E. I'm gonna hum it again. Could you tell when it came back down? It came back down. Could you tell that it started on do and it also ended on do? Woo. Yes. Now, if they were all half notes, do I need to color any of them in? No. And let's double check my stems. Am I following the stem rule? Have I made it up to that 1, 2, 3 way line with my note? Nope. So all of my stems need to point up. That's kind of fun. Dictation's a little trickier when we have to listen for the rhythm and the notes. Make sure you tell your teacher what you heard. Maybe right away you heard there were 5 notes. Maybe right away you heard that it ended on a mi, re, do. Maybe you heard that hiding there. Or right away you heard it start on a do and end on a do. We can use all of the different things we've been learning to figure out what the notes are that we're listening to. That's so fun. Okay, I have a new song that we get to sing. Now, it's one thing that's really fun about our Orange Root semester is a lot of our songs are going to need some sassy snaps. Do you know how to do sassy snaps? Even if you can't make the snapping noise with your fingers, you can still pretend you're doing sassy snaps. I like to call it snappitude. You got to have snappitude in our Orange Root semester. So open up to page 6 for me. This is gonna be our very first song that we're gonna need some snappitude on. And I think to help me out, I'm gonna put on a hat and some sunglasses. Mr. Rabbit, can you help me out with your magic? Should we try out our snappitude snaps? Hey now! Ooh, I definitely am gonna have some snappitude now. Take a look at page 6 for me. This is our cadence blues. Do you see in the picture? Our friends are wearing sunglasses there too. So if you have your sunglasses, put them on so we can look at this together. Now, for now, I want you to just point and snap and help me out. I'm gonna play it for you so you hear what it sounds like. It's in 4/4. That means it's gonna feel like watermelon. When you do the snap part, can you make it snappitude?
This is such a fun one.
C position, here we go.
Red, 2, 3. At the end, along with those snaps, you're gonna need some jazz hands now that we're in Orange Root semester. Now, did you notice when I was playing this song, did I play hands together? No. First time through, and you can see this written at the top, only my right hand will play. And then when I get down to the dot, dot, do it again, did you hear me say, get your left hand ready? Then your left hand will play on the second verse all the way to the end. Is that so fun? I love when we get to do our sassy snaps in our third year. Mr. Rabbit, I think it's time for bug school. Can you help me get ready? I'm gonna use my sassy snaps. Thanks, Mr. Rabbit. I love that he has magic all the time now. Do you think we should head off to bug school and see what our bugs are doing today? I wonder what they're gonna teach us now that we're in the Orange Root semester. So much fun, I'll see you there. Hey, we're in a new classroom. That's because we are getting so smart and we're getting bigger too. Can we do a quick review of our bug names? Sing with me.
Our bugs have great names, they're lots of fun. A bug is a quarter note, it gets 1. A slug is a half note, it gets 2. It has a little more work to do. A slug plus a dot, that equals 3. A dotted half note is its name, you see. Our whole note is our big bad note. 4 counts like Bill Grogan's goat.
Do you feel like you really know all of the names of all of those notes? I want to show you a magic trick. Do you remember this bug? What's it called? A beetle. A what? A beetle is two eighth notes joined together. Pull them apart. There's the arrow feather. Did you see what happened? I had my beetle and I pulled the beetles apart. And I have an arrow feather. Did you hear what I called it? A beetle is two eighth notes. Can you say eighth note? Our arrow feather notes must be called an eighth note. Have we ever seen arrow feather notes before? Yes. Do you remember back when we were playing Robin Hood and we learned about our shoot the? Look at what is at the end of that rhythm. It's an arrow feather note. And now you know that its name is actually a eighth note. You got it. What do you think the name of this note is? What does it look like? It kind of looks like a quarter note. And then what do you see behind it? Do you see that dot? It's just called a dotted quarter note. That's easy enough. And when we played our shoot the, we were actually playing a dotted quarter eighth. That's fun. Now, hey, when I have two eighth notes, it looks like this. Sometimes eighth notes like to hang out together. When I have an eighth note by itself, it looks like this. But when they get together, they like to take their arrow feathers and they like to join arms because they like to hang out together. They're such good friends. So this is two eighth notes. This is also two eighth notes. It's both of them. A beetle is two eighth notes joined together. You are going to have so much fun learning these new names. Now, I want to make sure, if you haven't already, did you get some new orange flashcards? Make sure you add them to the back of your purple deck. And for now, I want you to only unband up to, there's a white prompt card. Do you see how it says stop? So I want you to go up to that, go ahead and put the rest of those back in your rubber band. You can learn your eighth notes and your dotted quarter notes. That's gonna be so much fun now that we are in our orange root semester. Okay, I love that we get to count. Our bugs have great names. They're lots of fun. They really are so much fun. Bye, bugs. Mr. Rabbit, I think he got our room set up for us. Can you go ahead and grab some of your alphabet pieces with me? You're gonna need at least two. You and your grown-up can join me on the floor. Do you remember last year, in our second year, when we learned about our music alphabet? Can you sing our music alphabet with me? What did it start with? It started with a C, and what came next? D, E, F, G, A, B. Can we sing another one? Make sure your alphabet pieces are doing what mine are. C, D, E, F, G, A, B. Yes. Now, since we're in orange root semester, we're gonna learn how to do a different type of snake. We're still gonna start, but now we're going to make a skipping snake. So I'm gonna leave this one here for reference, and I'm gonna go ahead and start with my C. And now I need to skip. What letter normally comes after C? A D. I need to skip the D, and what letter would actually come next if I skip? It would actually be an E. Ooh, that's a little different already. Okay, now I'm on an E. What letter do I need to skip over? F. And what letter will come next? I'm skipping over F, and I get to a G. Now I'm on G. I'm on G, what comes after G? Letter A. I'm gonna skip over the A. And what will come next in my skipping snake? A B. Okay, let's keep going. I'm on B, but I know that my music alphabet can just keep going and going and going. I'm on a B. Skip over C. What will come next in my skipping snake? D. Now I'm on a D. I can skip over E. And what will come next? An F. And let's just double check ourselves. I'm on an F. I can skip over G. And an A. I now have a skipping snake. This skipping snake starts on the letter C. Now, if I made my skipping snake correctly, there will be secret messages hiding in my snake. Do you see any secret messages hiding in your snake?
Every good boy does fine.
Do you see that in your snake? Every good boy does fine. Yes. Do you think there's any other secret messages now that we know that one? What do you think? Bum, 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 bum. F-A-C-E. That one's there too. We just have to wrap around. What about the spaces in the bass clef? All cows eat grass. Let's see if it's there. All cows eat grass. What about the lines? Good. Bridges don't fall apart. Yay! All of our secret messages are hiding there in our snakes. That's how you'll be able to check to know that you did them right. Okay, can you stand up with me? I am so excited of where we get to go next. Can you sassy snap with me to get there? Oh my goodness! Where are we? Look at all my carrots in their little garden. I love it. What do you see over here? Can you tell me what the interval is from my special note to my note in the middle? His name is the third. Take a look at my top note. What do you think the interval would be? Pretend my middle's not there. Between my special note and my top note. He's known as the fifth. Exactly. But what about my special note? What do you think his name is? I'm going to need to put on my glasses to take a closer look. I want to figure out, what do you think? Is it the first? What's his special name? Can you help me with your sassy snaps? Help me out.
On any given note, you add a third and fifth, and you have made a triad that will give you such a lift. When it is stacked up so, no gaps will let you know the chord's in root position, so the root is down below.
Snap with me.
'Cause it's the root that gives the chord its name, and every chord has got to have a root. Let's find the root.
Oh, I'm glad I put these on. That was easier to tell. Did you hear? What was its name? It was called the root. Yes, it's not just a special note. And this is the root because, hey, it's just a slice of my carrot. It really is a root. That's so fun. Now, what is a root? Have you ever heard that word before? Not in music. Have you ever heard what a root is? It's the bottom of a plant. It's from that part of the plant that the rest of the plant grows. I think I want to take a little closer look at what the root of my carrots might look like. Oh, what's happening to our screen? Do you see the bottom of my carrots? Do you see their roots? Yes, in music, the root is the bottom of our chord, and it's from the root that the rest of the chord grows, and it's from the root that it gets its name. Ooh, that's so exciting! 'Cause it's the root that gives the chord its name. Yes, every chord has got to have a root. Now, have we ever seen chords in this position before? We have. And when the chord is stacked up like this, in thirds with no gaps, it's known as root position. The chord's in root position, so the root is down below. Let's look at a few other chords and let's see if they're in root position or not. I'm gonna move this. I'm gonna get rid of my special note for just a minute. We're not gonna need him anymore. What about this chord? Is it stacked up in thirds? Yes, the chord's in root position, so the root is down below. Let's change it. What about this chord? Is it stacked up? No. So the root can't be down below on this one. What about, let's try another one of these. What about, what do you think? Is it stacked up? No gaps? Then the chord's in root position and the root is down below. You got it. Let's sing our song again. And I'm going to move our root position triad down to here. Can you sing it with me? Where's your snaps?
On any given note, note. You add a third and fifth, and you have made a triad that will give you such a lift. When it is stacked up so, no gaps will let you know the chords in root position.
We should change it so the root is down below. There's the root,
'cause it's the root that gives the chord its name, and every chord has got to have a root. Let's find the root.
Now, what does this chord look like right now? Have we seen this root position chord before? This kind of looks like our red chord. Help me out a little bit. What are the pieces of my red chord? Do, mi, so. You got it. And check it out. There's our red chord. And look, he's been in root position the whole time. The chord's in root position, so the root is down below. Ooh, what is the root of my red chord? It's a do. Yes. Now, it's a do, but what letter is that? It's middle C. So when I'm in the key of C major, my red chord has a root of a do, but more important, it has the root of the letter name of C. Ooh, that's cool that we know the root of our red chord. Okay, what are the pieces of my blue chord? Can you sing it with me? Do, what comes next? Fa, la, and there's my Now, what do you think? Is my blue chord in root position? No, it is not stacked up. There's a great big gap here between my do and my fa. Now, I can mix up the pieces of my blue chord. We've been doing that as long as I keep a do and a fa and a la. It will still be a blue chord. So what is the letter note? I can see it's a do, but what is the letter note of my note that's on the bottom? It's my middle C. Can I find another C somewhere on the staff?
F, A, C.
Yes. What do you think? Do I still have all the pieces of my blue chord? I do. What do you think? Is my chord in root position now? Yes, this isn't a red chord. This is my blue chord in root position, and the root is down below. So what do you think? What is the root of my blue chord? What do you see? What's our solfege down there? It's actually a fa, but when I'm in the key of C major, what is the letter name? What is the root of my blue chord? Do you see that first space in the treble clef? What is it? It's actually an F. The root of my blue chord in C major is an F. I love that that's where we get the name of the chord. Okay, let's do that one last time with our yellow chord. What are the pieces of the yellow chord? Help me out. We have a T and a Re. And what's the top of our yellow chord? So. Does it look like it's in root position? No. Do you see that great big gap right there? Well, we can do the same thing as long as we keep the pieces. It's a yellow chord. Doesn't matter what the shape's going to end up. So what is the note that we have on the bottom? What's our letter name that that T is sitting on right now? Is that our middle B? Yes, I can see it. It's our middle B. Can we find another B somewhere on our staff? Every good boy does fine. Yes, I'm going to replace this T and I'm going to move it up to there. What do you think? Is it in root position now? No, but we can do that again. What is the note that's on the bottom of my chord right now? My Re is sitting on what letter? That's our middle D. You got it. Do I have any other Ds somewhere on my staff? As long as I keep the pieces, it'll still be a yellow chord. Every good boy does. Yes, do I still have all the pieces of my yellow chord? Its shape kind of looks like a red chord, but it's not. It's a yellow chord in root position. So the root is down below. So what is the root of my yellow chord? What is that? It's a so. So I'm going to say the root of my yellow is a so. But more importantly, when I'm in the key of C major, the root of my yellow chord is what letter? It's a G. Yes. That's so exciting. It's not about the shape. It's all about the pieces. These are all of my primary chords in root position. I wonder if we could find those anywhere in our songbooks. Should we head back to class? Can you sassy snap with me? I love it. Should we find some of those roots in our songbook? Open up to page 3 for me. What do you notice on page 3? What's the name of this song? Primary root chord song. We've played a primary chord song. I wonder how we would play this. Let's look at the very first chord. This is the red chord. Blue? Does that look like a blue chord? Well, we just learned that our blue chord can be in root position. When we're in the key of C major, my red chord, my very first chord there, what is the key? I'm gonna grab some crayons. Make sure you grab a red, a blue, and a yellow crayon so that you can write these in with me. What is the note that we see? It's a C. Can you take your crayon and actually draw? I'm going to actually use my keyboard like a desk. That'll make it easier, but I'm gonna draw a great big red C, because the root of my red chord when I'm in C major is a C. Okay, let's look at that blue chord. What is the root on the very bottom? It's an F. Can we draw in an F with our blue crayon? You got it. Okay, let's look at our yellow chord. It's a yellow chord in root position. What is the root of our yellow chord when we are in C major? It's a G. Let's draw. Oh, I can barely see. Let's make sure we can tell that it's a G with my yellow crayon. Okay, and then it ends back on our red chord, and we already figured that one out. It's a C. Okay, now do you think we could play this? And I told you, I love it, because you just need to know the root, and you put your thumb on it, and then you play the fingers like it feels like on a red chord. So let's try this. We already know the first one. We're putting our thumb on a C, which we already knew, and now let's play our red chord. This is the red chord. What's the root of the blue? It's an F. I'm gonna take my thumb and jump it up, put it on an F, make it feel like a red chord. 1, 3, 5. Blue is next, I said. What's the root of the yellow chord? A G. I don't have to jump very far for this one. My G is right next door to my F, but I'm gonna put my thumb on it. And then I want it to feel the same way it normally does when I play a red chord. Yellow is the chord that leads us back to, I'm gonna jump all the way down to, what's the root of my red chord? Woo! Red. Did you make your thumb jump down to a C to play it? That's a different way to play it. Now, did it still sound like the chords that we normally play? This is the red chord. Blue is next, I said. It still sounds blue because I still have all of the pieces of my blue chord. I've now just put them in our root position. Same thing with my yellow. Yellow is the chord. Even though it doesn't look like a yellow chord, do I have all the pieces of my yellow chord? Yeah, so it still sounds like it's the yellow chord. That leads us back to red. That's the way we normally play it. Now, take a look at the bottom two lines of this music. This is the way you've normally seen it. That's so fun that we can now see our regular chords, but what they look like and sound like when they're in root position. I think Edwina wants to come talk to us today. Mr. Rabbit, can you help her come out? Yay! She came to see us today. I love it when Edwina comes. Should we see what she has to say? That is big news. Do you know what she just said? She told me that this is her last week. And next week we will get to meet her grandpa. That's exciting. She told me he loves to compose and he does it with musical questions and answers. I can't wait to meet him, Edwina. We will miss you. Can we wave to Edwina? Bye. We are gonna miss Edwina. We've had fun with her. Do you know what it means to compose? Do you get to be a composer this semester? I wonder what that will be like to be able to be a composer. Wow, where are we? Hey, look, it's Beethoven and Mozart. A whole bunch of composers are on our wall. I bet this is where we get to learn to be a composer. Edwina was telling us about this. Can we open up in our book to page 21? What do you see on page 21? It's called Composer's Corner because this is where we will get to start to compose our own song. You're the composer. Do you see that line on the first page? Can you write your name right there on that line? I'm going to write my name. I'm going to write Miss Julie, because this is going to be my composition. Make sure you write your name there. And let's look at all the fun things we're going to work on together. Parents, there's a special page just for you if you want to take a look at that. But look at page 23 with me together. We get to be a composer. And the first thing we need to figure out is what our inspiration is going to be for our composition. An inspiration can be something that makes you happy. An inspiration can be something that just is your most favorite ever. Is there anything that you just love? It's your most favorite? I have a few things I love. I love to play the piano. I also love ice cream. Do you like ice cream? Those are all inspirations for me. I also like carrots. Do you know why? Carrots just inspire me. What are some things that inspire you? I want you to come up with a few ideas of what inspires you. You can write one, you can write 10. I want you to come up with as many ideas that inspire you, and you can go ahead and write them in, or you could even tell them to your grown-up. And that will get us started on what we are going to compose our song about. That'll be so fun. Inspirations can come from anywhere. I know we have a song that the inspiration is about an Irish fish merchant named Molly Malone. I wonder what she would look like. I'm Molly Malone. Can you open up in your books to page 12 for me? Let's see if we can find this song. Do I kind of look like the girl in the picture on page 12? This song is called Cockles and Mussels. What's the time signature of this song? 3/4. Is that going to feel like lollipop, lollipop? Yes. Hey, do you see some of our new eighth notes that we just learned about? Do you see our arrow feathers? We know how to count our shoota. Do you see any dotted half notes in this song? I see a lot of dotted half notes in this song. Check out the left hand. What kind of chords do we see in the left hand? It almost looks like a lot of red chords. I think it might be a lot of chords in root position. I think it'll be fun if we could clap the bug rhythms while we listen. Can you and your grown-up get your clappers ready? Let's see what the bugs are. Bug. Shoot the bug, 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 bug. Shoot the bug, 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 bug. Shoot the bug, 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 bug. Slug. Bug. Shoot the bug, 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 bug. Shoot the bug, bug, bug. Ooh, there's a beetle. Bug. Bug, 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 bug. Shoot the bug, slug. Did you see the one beetle hiding? Where was it? It was on the very last line. Bug, bug, beetle. Yes. Otherwise, there are a lot of our shoot the bug rhythms in this song. This week, you're going to practice line by line. Each line you'll play 3 times. Let's do that together on just the first line. So we'll start with my G, C, 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 C. Skip up to E, skip down to C. Let's do it again. G. Were you able to do it without my helps? Let's do it one more time. G down to C. Skip up to E, down to C. Ooh, I really feel like I know that line really well after playing it 3 times. Then I can move on to the next line and play it 3 times. Work each line by line. Okay, I think it's time for our puppet show. Are you ready for a brand new puppet show? I think our puppets are playing a game of hide and seek. I hope we don't scare them or mess up their game. We're going to sneak in really quietly. The monsters are playing hide and seek in a swamp. They're hiding. Do you think you can help me find them? I wonder who the first one is. Can you hear them at the same time? Here it comes. Do you hear Frankenstein? Do you hear the dragon and Frankenstein? Together. Should I go with me? Oh my goodness, did that scare you at the end? Did all of the monsters come out of their hiding places at the very end? I love that puppet show. It was a little tricky. Some of our puppets were happening at the same time. If you open up in the back of your homework book on page 48, there's a page that will help you be able to hear which puppets are happening at the same time. Can you see them? They're in these brackets. But that's such a fun one. Listen very carefully for this guy. He's the hardest one to hear. Should we let him keep playing their game of hide and seek? Let's sneak back to class. I'll see you there. That was so much fun. I think it's time for my friend to come play with us. Come on over. This is our friend Ruthie. Hi, Ruthie. Can you wave hi to everybody at home? Today, Ruthie is going to help us. I think we should play Smarties on the Staff. Should we play Smarties on the Staff together? Can you and your grown-up get out your smart staff and whatever you're going to use for Smarties? I actually have Smarties, so we can use these today. Do you want to sit down with me? I want you to choose whatever clef you think you need more work on. What do you think, Ruthie? Should we do the bass clef today, or should we do the treble clef? Oh, Ruthie says the bass clef. So we're gonna place these all over. Grown up, if you wanna place whatever you're using for your Smarties all over the lines and the spaces in the bass clef, I'm gonna push them all over the place, Miss Ruthie, so that we can play our Smarties on the Staff together. If you think you want to do the bass clef, go ahead and put them there. If you want to work on just the treble clef, you can put them there. Or if you really want, you can do the whole staff. But Ruthie and I are just gonna be working on just the notes in the bass clef. Do you think I've got them all over the place? Okay, Ruthie and I are gonna do a few together. You ready? What's the first one?
A.
It is an A. It's the first space. You got it. Ooh, what's this one? It's on the first line.
G.
It is a G. What's this one? Ooh, it's on a line. What is this one?
F.
It is an F. You're doing so good. Yay! We found them all. Ruthie found them all. Did you find all of the Smarties on your staff? Thank you, Miss Ruthie. You want to stand up with me? Thank you so much for playing with me today. Can we say goodbye to our friends at home? Yay! Thank you so much. I will see you next time. Wow! We did so many fun things on our very first lesson of orange roots. Can you say goodbye with me? Let's say goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. Let's say goodbye. I'll see you next week. Let's take a look at what our homework is going to be today. I can't believe we're in our orange root semester. Okay, lots of chords on this page. You need to find the ones that are in root position over on our practicing. Now that you know all of your flashcards, you're going to shuffle up the deck every time you do it. At least 2 days a week, I want you to look at the note, say it, and then play it on the keyboard where it lives. At least 3 days a week, can you time yourself and go through the deck as fast as you can? You won't do the play it part on that one. I just want you to name the note, name the note, name the note. On our practicing, we're going to be playing that primary root chord song. I love root position triads because you just need to know where to put your thumb, and then you play from there, C major scale. Play each hand separately and then try hands together. Okay, cadences. Notice there's two page numbers on cadences. When it says page 6, you're going to be playing our cadence blues song that we did with our Sassy Snaps today. But sometimes it will say page 7. That means you're actually just playing one of our regular cadences. That'll be on page 7, and you'll want to choose a different one every time you play it. Maybe you play one in F major. Maybe you play one in C minor, but don't try to play that one with your cadence blues track. It won't work out. And then cockles and muscles. Start working on that right hand, working it line by line so that you really have it solid in your hands. Have so much fun this week. Thanks for playing with me.